Amen, amen. Well, praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. This is me, Apostle Esther. I pray that you are already having an amazing day. Thank you so much for joining me. I want to thank all of my new subscribers. I want to thank everyone that is sharing, liking, and those of you that have already subscribed to my YouTube channel, thank you so much. You already know if you are a subscriber, you receive that notification bell each time I upload content. And that bell notifies you, it alerts you that my content is viewable and it is also shareable. So again, thank you for joining me. Also, a quick reminder that my book is available. Believers Believe and Believers Receive. It is available on Amazon. Why don't you go ahead and go over there and get your copy on today? We're super excited about this project. It'll bless you. It will bless your life. One of the excerpts from the book says that the manifestation moves or navigates us to a place to become what we're believing in God. What we're believing God for. So your faith is going to take you to that place. Whatever you are believing God for, stay in that place of faith and watch God manifest your life. Well, listen, because I already feel that teacher's anointing, but I'm going to give you a moment to get your Bibles, to get your notepads. As always, I am going to hang out right here. I'm going to review some of my notes, and we're coming back with the word of the Lord for today that's going to bless your life, that's going to inspire you, that's going to motivate you. So we're going to hang out right here. We'll be right back. God bless you. As promised, we are right back. So thank you so much for sticking around and hearing what the Lord has to say to us on today. Listen, this morning my husband and I were talking, and he was talking about enjoying life, what we do to enjoy life. And I just want to ask you a question. How many of us are really, really, really thoroughly, completely in the fullness? How many of us are enjoying life? St. John 10:10 says, "The thief cometh not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus said, I am come that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly." That Amplified says that we may enjoy life, have it in abundance to the full till it overflows. One of the other translations says that we can live life to the fullest. And Apostle Chris and I are learning that, you know, the enemy really does not want us to enjoy life. So many things can come at you from the north, the east, the south, and the west. It looks like if you fix one thing, something else goes crazy. But we have to rely on the word of the Lord, just like I was reading from my book. We have to fully rely on the word of God to become what we believe. We have to believe God's word to stand in that place until God manifests our faith. And so the Bible says in John 10:10 that the Lord Jesus said, "I am come to give you life, that you will enjoy life in the abundance to the full, to the overflow." Yes, we know that the enemy is coming to steal, to kill, and to destroy, but Jesus's word is more powerful than any word of the enemy. So we have to learn to get our ears programmed and tuned to hear the voice of the Lord, even in the midst of trouble, in the midst of storms, in the midst of temptations, in the midst of trials. What is the Lord speaking to you in that moment? And I always say this, excuse me, once we hear a word, once we receive a word from the Lord, that is the word that we hold onto. That is the word of faith. That is the word of faith that saves us. That is the word of faith that heals us. That is the word of faith that delivers us. That is the word of faith that gives us victory. So when we hear the word of the Lord, we must take a hold on to the word of God and stay in that place until we see God bring manifestation in and concerning our lives. I love what Apostle Chris says. Faith has to reach its destiny when we're believing God for something. So I want to encourage you on the day to go ahead and put that on your bucket list. Amen. That faith is going to reach its destiny concerning this thing. The word of the Lord says that we can enjoy life. We need to take a fresh breath. We need to get back to the word of God and understand God says what he means and he means what he says. We are going to enjoy life. Come on, make that confession. Come on, open up your mouth and say, I am going to enjoy life in the abundance to the full till it overflows. That is a promise that God has given us that we will have abundant life and we need to enjoy the life that God has given us. If you're not enjoying your life, then you need to check yourself and see what it is that's causing you not to walk in a prosperous place. What's causing you not to walk in a fruitful place? What's causing you not to be able to enjoy that life that God has spoken about in his word? I am already excited that we started our day off talking about enjoying the abundant life. You know, we have to just silence every voice and hear what God is saying. Take God at the authority of his word and know that God has already spoken. And when God has spoken, he's spoken well concerning our lives. And we need to take ownership of that word and watch God do what he said he was going to do concerning our lives. He spoke in Genesis. He spoke in Revelations. He spoke in Malachi. He spoke in John. He's speaking right now that we should enjoy life in the abundance to the full until it overflows. Well, you already know I am Apostle Esther, super excited about the assignment that the Lord has me on. I am an ambassador of the Lord Jesus Christ. That means that I'm a good news carrier. I'm here to encourage all of us, to inspire us, to motivate us to go ahead and enjoy the abundant life. Have an amazing day. We will be back on this week talking about enjoying the abundant life. Have an amazing day. God bless you.